Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Blazor Context Menu component from Syncfusion. There are real-time scenarios where you would want to avoid dockable menu headers in applications and instead show a limited set of choices in the context menu that opens when right-clicking or performing a touch and hold action. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Blazor Context Menu component from Syncfusion to a server-side Blazor application. I will also show you how to configure a few of its basic features like item binding, multi-level nesting, adding icons, and navigation links. To explore other features available in Syncfusion Blazor Context Menu, refer to the website link in the above card. Let me start with the application creation process. You can create a Blazor application by using either Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or a later version. I open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. I select the Blazor app from the templates and click the Next button. Here, I name my project and click the Create button. Here, I will choose the Blazor Server app and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a context menu to it. To add and start using a context menu, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I open the NuGet Package Manager, search for Syncfusion Blazor, and install it in my application. Once it is installed, the Blazor packages are added to this application's packages folder. Now, to render a context menu, first I navigate to the imports.eraser page and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Navigations. Then I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. For that, I navigate to the startup.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace and make a call to the Syncfusion Blazor service method inside the configure services method. And within the configure method, I register the Syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I navigate to the host.cshtml page to add CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, the configuration steps are done. To know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, please check the video link shown in the above card. Let me continue to add the Blazor context menu now. For that, I open the index component. Here, I can open the context menu on any target element. First, I need to add the target div element with ID. Using the ID, I add the height and border to the target element. Then I include the SF context menu tag, set the target property, and assign the target element's ID to show the context menu options on this specific target element. The context menu is not visually displayed on the browser now, as there are no menu items in it. To visualize the context menu on a target element in the browser page, I need to add appropriate menu items to it. I'm going to show you how to add menu items now. To add items, I can directly write the C# code here using @code directive. To create a menu items, let me first create a public variable menu items of the type list and then create a list of menu items. I then include the text property to specify the caption of the menu item and set its value to cut. Similarly, I define other items and assign this menu items list to the items property of the context menu. Now, I run my application by pressing FI key. You can see the output displaying the context menu items. Next, I will show you how to add icons to the context menu items to provide visual representation of an action. For that, I include the icon CSS property in the item cut and define the CSS class e-cut with content. I then assign this class name along with e-icons to the icon CSS property. See the output, an icon is displayed on the item cut. Now I will show you how to set multi-level nesting in context menu. I can map the items property to any item to our child items. Here I will add the items property to the item paste and create a list with merge formatting and keep source formatting. See the output. When I hover over the item paste, its child items are displayed. Next, I will show you how to navigate in the context menu while clicking on any of the menu items. I navigate simply by adding the target web page to the URL property. Here, for example, I add the new item navigate, set the Syncfusion documentation link to the URL property. See the output. When I click the item navigate, it will be redirected to the Syncfusion documentation page. Finally, I will show you how to customize the list items using the onItemRender event. Here, I add the context menu events property, include the onItemRender event, and assign a value render. In the render method, I add the class custom to each list item. Inside the custom class, I include the style as float left and font style as italic with some other styles. See the output. List items are customized in the context menu. Let me summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor server app and add a context menu component to it. And then I showed you a few of its basic features like item binding, multi-level nesting, adding icons, and navigation links. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.